You're watching South Asia Newsline, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 1st of May. GST collection in India hits record high of 2.10 trillion rupees in April. Pakistani lawmaker makes call of action against forced conversion of Hindu girls. And Bangladesh's cruel heat wave takes toll on pet shop animals. And now for all the details. India collected a record 2.10 trillion rupees as gross goods and services tax in April, a rise of 12.4% from the same period last year, the government said in a statement on Wednesday. The government had collected 1.87 trillion rupees as GST in the same period last year. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, in a post on X, said that GST collections breach landmark milestone of 2 trillion rupees. After refunds, the government's net GST mop-up rose 17.1% year-on-year to 1.92 trillion rupees, the statement said. The collection in April is usually higher as taxpayers clear their dues when India's financial year ends in March. And over 60 schools in India's capital, New Delhi, on Wednesday received a bomb threat via email, which triggered panic among parents and prompted students to stay at home. While the students were being evacuated from schools, the Delhi police, dog squads and bomb disposal squads stepped up vigil. The police in a statement called the incident a hoax and said they have conducted a thorough check of all the schools as per the protocol. Delhi's Lieutenant Governor V.K. Saxena also inspected Davy School in Model Town and assured citizens of safety and said that the culprits behind this incident will not be spared. He further said that the police have traced the location where the mails were coming from. Similar threats have been sent to schools in New Delhi in the past but turned out to be hoaxes.
जैसे ही इसकी खबर स्कूलों में आई है, इमीडिएटली पुलिस को इन्फॉर्म किया गया है स्कूल अथॉरिटीज़ ने और दिल्ली पुलिस बहुत ही जल्दी वहाँ पर पहुँची और सारा कॉर्डन ऑफ कर दिया गया है एरिया. सर्च ऑपरेशंस चल रहे हैं. यहाँ पर डॉग स्क्वाड्स भी हैं, बॉम्ब डिस्पोजल यूनिट्स भी काम कर रही हैं. हर तरीके से हम मुस्तैद हैं.
मूविंग ऑन. Amid the disturbing rise in the forced abduction, conversion and marriage of Hindu girls in Pakistan, a lawmaker from the minority community has appealed for action over the critical issue. A report.
A Pakistani MP on Tuesday made an emotional appeal for help in the Senate as he raised the issue of abduction and forceful conversion of minority Hindu girls in the country. Danesh Kumar, a Hindu lawmaker in Pakistan, addressing the upper house of the parliament, said, Sindh was a land of Sufism, has now become a hotbed for forced conversion of minority girls. Referring to the case of Priya Kumari, a Hindu girl who went missing from Sukkur in 2022 during the Muharram procession, Kumar said it has been nearly 2 years since her abduction, but authorities have failed to take action against the culprits. I fear that the innocent girl too has been converted, the senator said. He lamented if such actions by the extremists continue unabatedly, there will be a time when there will be no Hindu left in Pakistan.
Priya Kumari, Muharram ke mahine mein, wo azadarin ko unke walidain pani pila rahe the. Choti 6 saal masoom bachi hai, usko agwa kiya jata hai Priya Kumari ko. Abhi 2 saal guzar gaye, uska pata nahi, aur Priya Kumari ko jisne agwa kiya uska naam nominate hai wo bhi pakke ka daku hai magar us par koi Sindh government haath nahi uthati aur uske taane bane ek siyasi shakhsiyat se milte hain magar jurrat nahi hoti kisi ki ke usko pakad kar jail mein dale taaki hamari Priya Kumari azad ho sake. Hamari puri duniya mein badnaami ho rahi hai aur hum aankhein band karke baithe hue hain.
Religious minorities in Pakistan have been subjected to continued oppression and persecution. According to a report by Gatestone Institute in 2023, Hindu and Christian women and children face the risk of being kidnapped, forcibly converted, raped and coerced into a marriage with an older or elderly man. Activists have repeatedly condemned the religious persecution of minority communities and have called on the government to bring legislation for equal status for all communities.
In a fresh twist in the Cypher case, the Islamabad High Court has observed that the Federal Investigation Agency has nothing to prove that the jailed former PM Imran Khan retained the confidential diplomatic cable and it went missing from his possession. PTI founder Imran Khan was indicted in the Cypher case in October 2023 for allegedly brandishing the classified document during a public rally, just 2 weeks before the ouster of his PTI government in April 2022. He had claimed it as a proof of a conspiracy against his government by a foreign power. He is now serving 10 years of imprisonment in the Cypher case. High Court Justice Aurang Zeb remarked that politicians make such statements to pander to the crowd. Later, the bench deferred hearing of the case till May 2nd for further proceedings. Unprecedented snowfall and cold weather in Afghanistan for the past few days has disrupted the lives of many, with farmers and gardeners being the most affected. Gardeners in the Nirk district said that their fruit trees, which were in flower season, have been destroyed, causing huge financial losses to almost 2,000 families in the region. 53-year-old Gulajan, who has two gardens of apricot trees and apples, said that all of his 15-member family's income has been lost due to snowfall. He said snowfall at this time of the year is completely unprecedented and demanded that the authorities to help the affected farmers.
او بهدار دیم قدم منمی سگ بهدار خسارمان شدیم زیاد نمی نفقه اولاد ما بودی من چکی ما بودی را بین برد
مردم ما بیشتر در کنار رودخانه زندگی میکنن و آگاهی کمتر و پیش بینی ها و هشداری دهی های بین المللی و ادارات داخلی کشور دارن از این جهت مردم ما بسیار زیاد منتظر میشه ما شما دیدیم که نه تنها که خسارات جانی بر مردم ما وارد میشه بلکه خسارات که از درک از بین رفتن باغایشان از بین رفتن زمینای زراعتیشان برشان وارد میشه بسیار زیاد انگفته
With a week-long heat wave sweeping across Bangladesh, pet shops in the capital Dhaka have been doing what they can to cool their animals down. The severe heat wave led to temperatures climbing above 43 degrees Celsius earlier on Monday. In such extreme heat, animals could be susceptible to heat stroke. Pet shop owners in Dhaka's Katabon, the main pet market in the country, were seen spraying water on the animals and birds. They also frequently provided the animals with electrolyte drinks and hydrating food.
এই গরমে আমরাও টিকতে পারতেছি না পশু পাখিরও সেম অবস্থা আমরা সকালবেলা পাখিদেরকে খাবার দেওয়ার আগে ওদেরকে স্প্রে করে দিচ্ছি এবং পানির সাথে স্লাইন দিচ্ছি আর আমরা যতটা সম্ভব এটা দোকান খোলা রাখার চেষ্টা করি প্রায় 16 ঘন্টায় দোকান খোলা রাখি
Temperatures in southwest Bangladesh have remained high for over a week without any sign of storm or rain. An unusual change in weather, according to experts. Schools across the country have been shut till 2nd of May unless the heat dissipates. Jammu and Kashmir is not just known for its breathtaking landscapes and serene lakes, but also for its rich cultural heritage. Srinagar, the capital of Jammu and Kashmir, has seen a deep-rooted musical tradition that is reflected in its traditional instruments. Traditional musical drum, known as Tumbak Nadi, is still popular in the valley and is used in cultural and traditional folk activities. It plays a major role in attracting audiences and making events colorful.
जो ये तमख नारी है तो मिट्टी से ही बनती है, और जो तमख नारी के बाद जो इसके ऊपर खाल होती है वो बिल्कुल साफ करनी पड़ती है, जैसे जैकेट से बनाते हैं और वही इस खाल इसमें भी इस्तेमाल होती है। लेदर लेदर जो होता है वो इसी में इसमें भी इस्तेमाल होता है, क्योंकि जो ये तमख नारी है ये जो लेदर इसके ऊपर लगता है ये बिल्कुल साफ होना चाहिए, और इसके ऊपर हमको मेहनत करनी पड़ती है क्योंकि ये पूरा साफ करना पड़ता है ताकि जो ड्रम की आवाज़ आनी चाहिए बहुत अच्छी आनी चाहिए।
The preparation of this traditional drum is unique, and experienced potters make it by using a particular soft mud. For better sound results, potters use specific soft leather, and they give different color combinations to attract customers. The demand for the percussion instrument is quite high, especially during marriage season.
तुम्बकनारी संगीत में म्यूजिक में एक रीड की हैसियत का काम करती है। तुमक नारी को हम रिदम इंस्ट्रूमेंट इस्तेमाल करते हैं, एज प्रकशन इंस्ट्रूमेंट इस्तेमाल करते हैं कश्मीर में। यहाँ पे ज़्यादा लोग पैड वगैरह का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, लेकिन शादियों में तुमक नारी के बगैर चलेगा नहीं। मेन इंस्ट्रूमेंट तुमक नारी ही है शादी में, तुमक नारी और मटका।
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.